Yo sí yo es fácil la sí tiene de pelea.
Chef Manny. Beautiful. Oui, beautiful.
So family, this is my flour and I've actually sieved it. So it's optional, but I'll make sure that there is no sengemenge in your flour. So now I told you it's just two ingredients, you know. But so that it's not be like with me or complain, so I added salt. It's quite optional and I'm going to stir this together. This is the easiest bowl you can see. Ever. I have different methods of making spring roll paper, but this is the first one of the easiest. So make sure you subscribe to my YouTube channel. I'll create a playlist where you'll be seeing them. So I'll be adding my water bit by bit. This one is a no measurement recipe because you go, you pay as you go, you pour as you go. So if you're adding water to a particular consistency, you know, like when your ancestor tell you to do, but not to continue. So I'm not using just plain water, I'm using like warm water. So I just boiled water, then I mixed it with my normal cold water. Then I put warm water. So I shall be adding this small scoop like this. So you could do 1 cup of flour for 1 cup of water or 1.5 cup of water. I don't know what you mean. The type of flour varies, sha. You don't know that. So flour me tea ki jura wano. Me tea expire. One count of one. Kono sha ma show. Thank you. to look at the consistency. Not too watery and not too thick. You know that you've done the one that you can. So container and sieve. This sieve is not neat because I told you I used to sieve my flour. I cannot wash and sieve 100 times. So I'm going to pour it our mixture. To sieve out all the cocoa. This is the simplest and easiest recipe you see out there. If you've loved it up to here, I know you don't know what we're about doing, like. You can't imagine yet, but shall subscribe to my YouTube channel. Here's a go. To invite your friends, invite your food vendor families, and so you can be doing it in batches that you to take control. So make sure you scrape everything, butter, butter. So just use your spatula to shade the belly so that it's clear. This is my morning food though. I don't need jam, so I don't ask jam. So can you see that we're not wasting anything? I'm telling you that this is your post food spoon. Now make sure that the mesh you're using, the sieve you're using is very thin. If you're using a bigger one, everything will just fall inside. Oh yeah, you understand or you don't understand? I'm sure you understand. Look at it. Are you seeing it? Are you seeing the consistency? Not too watery, not too thick. So now, our next is. So this is my biggest pot. I have a frying pan. Please don't let this method scare you. I just have big things because of what I do. So I'm sure normal student or family can have small pan. You understand? Smaller pan. So I'm just going to be putting it on it. And it's the same size, almost the same size. So I'll put butter inside that pot. I'll leave it to boil. So here to my pan. It's not sticky over time. It's just behave like it's sticky. I don't know if it's my yellow bean. So if I show you on is non-stick, you can skip this. But if you are not sure, you can do this. But if you are sure but you are not sure, make sure you do this. So I'm just going to be rubbing the beans.
So I'm just going to leave it so.
Use very small oil as much as you can. So make sure it's properly done, like it's almost as if it's coming out itself. I'm cooking the other side as well. Not like one spoon first. To make sure it's flat. It took me a lot of trials and errors to get this, but now I'm sharing my mistake with you so you can learn.
Chef Mani, people, oh, yeah, people.